Hey guys, how's it going? So for those who don't know, I love video games, and today I want to talk about interactive storytelling. Let's get into it. Games like God of War and Uncharted and Halo are linear stories. You run around, you shoot up some baddies, and then they play a cutscene, and then you go to the next level. That's not what I want to talk about today. I want to talk about decisions, games where there's a lot of if-then statements, games where you can change the arc of the story, change the plot, change the dialogue based off of the character or the player's decisions.
I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I hope I've at least done some good here.
But even though they closed, didn't close, I don't know if they're coming back, I don't know what the situation is, but Telltale Games, I loved Telltale Games, especially The Walking Dead, and I'm also extremely excited about season 2 of The Wolf Among Us. So this is a good example of a game where you can make decisions. You can decide what to say, what not to say, whose side to take, and things like that. Even though I do have some gripes with The Walking Dead, where I felt like, actually both of them, both The Walking Dead and The Wolf Among Us, where it felt like, yeah, you made a bunch of decisions, but it felt like a sandbox, like one room, right, with one exit. Like, you can go in that room, you can do whatever you want to do, but you all have to leave the same. The stories kind of always wrap up the same. So with all the branches and all the arcs of the story, you kind of end up in the same place. But I do look at that as still a great example of a video game where you can learn a lot about interactive storytelling. So it's really difficult, and I'm sure it's very costly, to make video games where the player can make all these different choices and make and have all these different outcomes, all these different endings, because that's a lot of programming, that's a lot of programming hours, writing hours, and definitely for writers like us, it's a lot with a flow chart. So with flow charts, it allows you to have this graph where you can say, if this happens, then this happens. If this is said, then this is said. And you can keep making these little patches until you get to an ending or multiple endings and things like that. And by the way, we're talking about video games here, but this would also be practical if you were writing for AI. So if you have like an AI system, maybe, I don't know, you're writing Skynet or something like that. You come into your house and you say, oh man, I sure am tired. The AI can say, okay, he said, I'm tired, so what do I say now? Okay, oh, did you get was it a long day or something like that? There's people that write for AI, so I just wanted to bring that up too as something that's relevant. So another thing I want to talk about is world building. World building is extremely important because, I mean, it's important in all stories, but it's particularly important in video games because the player gets to kind of walk around the world, he gets to bump into different NPCs, listen to this, see how the buildings and the world is constructed, and it plays a very large role into giving him all the details and all the information he knows about this new level or this new world that he entered or things like that. So when it comes to the aspects of building, of world building, obviously there's a lot of factors here. What does the world look like? Are there aliens? Are they not aliens? Obviously these are a lot of factors, but the most important conflict is always the most important thing you should focus on. But in that conflict, what is the politics of that world? What are two very fair points competing parties have about the world and the direction of the world, the direction of the city, the direction of the company or whatever? And the better you can make that politics where they both make really good points, the easier it will be to force the player to make a tough decision. And to add to that, not just having a difficult decision, but also a urgent one. It's important to create urgency in that decision making. I can't even tell you how many times I've made terrible decisions in video games, and it's just because the NPCs were yelling at me to move faster, when probably there wouldn't have been any consequence if I waited. I feel like overall, movies allow you to feel the way the character feels, and video games allow you to live in the character's shoes. So this is something that I really want to delve into later. I'm going to do another part to interactive storytelling because I love this topic and I think it's extremely interesting. But for right now, if you found this interesting, please leave a like. If you like this kind of content and you want to see more, consider subscribing. I have more coming for you. So thank you so much for watching this. I'll see you soon.